ये जिस्म है तो क्या, ये रूह का लिबास है, ये दर्द है तो क्या, ये इश्क की तलाश है, फना किया मुझे ये चाहने की आस ने, तरह तरह शिकस्त ही हुआ।
ओ हेलो, हैप्पी न्यू ईयर।
Yep, I have already made it awkward, but welcome to the podcast, guys. इसका नाम है छोटी छोटी बातें, and today we're gonna talk about Kama Sutra. Yep, it's not all about sex, okay? Wait till the end, and you'll get to know a lot about it. So, sex has a huge history with India, something that we consider pure and important, and something that is the main root of our existence. And still, the sex education in India sucks. We are too scared to talk about it openly. I mean, bolna to chodo. I'll tell you about the story when I was going to buy the condom for the first time. I was really cool about it. But it wasn't that cool with the people around me because they were looking at me weirdly. And I was like, bro, it's just the condom. Tumhare wajah se population badh raha hai. At least I'm controlling it. But, so, anywho, let's talk about what a human consists of. Yeah, so basically a human is a combination of different characteristics. Okay, so these characteristics are the physical, the spiritual, the emotional, the mental, and sexual. So, these five characteristics hain. Each person has different types of combination, but everyone has the same elements. Okay. बस ये होता है कि कुछ लोगों में एक फीचर कुछ ज़्यादा होता है या दूसरा फीचर कुछ ज़्यादा होता है, राइट? सेक्सुअलिटी इज़ इम्पॉर्टेंट टू द इंडिविजुअल एज एनी अदर ऑफ दीज फीचर्स एंड इट नेवर लीव्स द इंडिविजुअल. नाउ देयर आर मेनी सेक्सुअलिटी, ओके, मेनी डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ सेक्सुअलिटी दैट आर प्रेजेंट. अ पर्सन कैन बी वर्जिन. वर्जिन इज समवन हु हैज़ नेवर हैड सेक्स. So, once a person has had sex, he or she is no longer virgin. There is another term that is born again virgin, and it is used by someone to describe the person who is no longer a virgin, but is now seeking for a new start. So, some newly religious people see it as a label for a spiritual renewal and a commitment to only have sex within marriage in future. Some women feel so pressured by the place that virginity has, the value of virginity, that they are driven to have hymen reconstruction surgery. Matlab, itna zyada pressure hai abhi bhi society mein about virginity and stuff. There's another thing called chastity, and chastity is generally understood as an act of saving yourself sexually for a particular time or a person. So, some people take a vow of chastity because they believe that it keeps them sexually pure. The vow may be taken for religious reasons as well. And there is another thing called celibacy. So, celibacy is generally understood as abstaining from sexual activity. Most people practice celibacy for religious reasons, like none, if I'm not wrong. तो ये तो बात हो गई अबाउट द डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ सेक्सुअलिटी दैट इज़ प्रेजेंट आउट देयर, राइट? अभी हम लोग बात करेंगे कि जो हिंदुइज्म है उसमें सेक्स को क्या मान्यता दी है और ये सेंशुअल प्लेजर और ये सब जो इसको क्या मान्यता दी गई है. सो मैनी हिंदूज बिलीव दैट सेंशुअल प्लेजर इज़ वन ऑफ द फोर लेजिटिमेट गोल्स टू बी सॉट इन लाइफ. द कामा इंक्लूड्स सेक्सुअल प्लेजर एंड सेक्स इज कंसिडर्ड टू बी अ गुड थिंग टू बी एन्जॉयड विद इन सर्टेन बाउंड्रीज. सेल्फ कंट्रोल इज़ एन इम्पॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट ऑफ हिंदू टीचिंग्स और ये हम सब भूल जाते हैं, राइट? ड्यूरिंग द सेकेंड द आश्रमा सेक्शुअल एक्टिविटी इन अ लविंग एंड कमिटेड रिलेशनशिप इज एनकरेज्ड. दिस इज बिकॉज हैविंग चिल्ड्रन इज व्यूड एज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ द लाइफ एंड ऑल्सो बिकॉज द कामा इज अ वैलिड एम इन लाइफ. मेनी हिंदूज वुड ओनली सीक सेक्शुअल प्लेजर and other forms of karma within the guidelines of dharma and ahimsa. So basically sexual activity should not involve harming others physically, emotionally or through neglect. Within these boundaries, sexual pleasure is celebrated in some Hindu teachings. जैसे कि द कामा सूत्रा इज अ रिस्पेक्टेड गाइड टू फिजिकल प्लेजर बेस्ड अपॉन द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ लव एंड म्यूचुअल रिस्पेक्ट. इट ऑल्सो includes guidance on self-respect and respect for the other sex, tenderness and care for the partner, so that there is a emotional and spiritual pleasure given and gained, not just physical. और ये सब हम लोग भूल जाते हैं, है ना, क्योंकि जब भी हम लोग बात करते हैं ब्रो सेक्सुअल चीज़ें जो हैं उसमें फोटोज एंड एवरीथिंग. द ओरिजिनल टेक्स्ट ऑफ कामा सूत्रा डज नॉट इवन इंक्लूड अ सिंगल पिक्चर. तो जो बताया जाता है, जो रूमर्स हैं, दैट इज प्रोबेबली डेराइव्ड वर्जन ऑफ कामा सूत्रा मे बी, जो बाकी लोगों ने लिखा है. और वेरी लिटिल इज नोन अबाउट द ओरिजिन्स ऑफ कामा सूत्रा. नो पोर्शन ऑफ द ओरिजिनल टेक्स्ट हैज सर्वाइव्ड. इट वॉज प्रोबेबली रिटन इन संस्कृत बाय वत्स्यायना. He seems to have been compiled the sexual habits and he blame other scholars for inventing some of the very difficult sexual positions. So ye wahi ho gaya jo remake banti hai na aajkal movies ka, achhi khasi movie hogi usko pura kharab kar denge. So that is the main thing over here. let's get back. The Kama Sutra is neither exclusively or predominantly a sexual manual or sex positions. Right, it does not encourage that, but it is written as a guide to the art of living well, the nature of love, finding a life partner, maintaining one's life, one's love life, and other aspect of pertaining to pleasure oriented facilities or of human life. The text is a mix of prose and Anushtup meter poetry verses. The text acknowledges the Hindu concept of Purushastra and lists desire, sexuality and emotional fulfillment as one of the proper goals of life. Its chapters discuss methods of courtship, training in the art or to be social engaging, finding a partner, flirting, maintaining power in a married life, when and how to commit adultery, sexual positions and other topics. So the majority of the book is about the philosophy and the theory of love, what triggers desire, what sustains it, and how and when is it good or bad. So it's not just about sex, right? It's beyond that. Vatsyayana's Kama Sutra states it has 1,250 verses distributed over 36 chapters in 64 sections, organized in 7 books. This statement is included in the opening chapter of the text. Ye common practice thi ancient writers ki, so that the popular text can reach to more people and in an original format. So the Kama Sutra uses a mixture of prose and poetry, and the narration has the form of dramatic fiction, where two characters are called the Nayaka, that is the man, and Nayika, woman, aided by the characters called the Pitamarda, Vita, and Vidushika. This format follows the teaching found in the Sanskrit classic named the Natyashastra. The teaching and the discussion found in Kama Sutra extensively incorporates ancient Hindu mythology and legends. While we are talking about Hindu mythology or sex, और हम लोग खाजुराहो की बात नहीं करें, ऐसा तो हो नहीं सकता, right? जिन लोगों को नहीं पता about खाजुराहो, so it is a group of Hindu and Jain temples in Chhatarpur district, that is in Madhya Pradesh. It's about 175 kilometers southeast of Jhansi. So जब वहाँ जाते हैं ना, you'll get varied reactions from people who visit the town and the temple of Khajuraho. While some are cynical, others cringe. A few are embarrassed and others disappointed. The guides with the poker face points towards an oral activity or a group activity. While most tourists giggles, others look away. The sculptures are grouped into 5 categories, okay? So the first categories are the cult images and they are built exactly as prescribed in the manual. That is the Shilpa Shastra. So you can see some of them carved as Tirthankaras, in Jain Museum. The second category are the ones you see in relief or niches, and they usually represent attendants, the guardians, the deities, the Gandharvas, the Shivganas, the Ashtadevalas. The third is the Apsaras, also referred to as the Sapnasundaris. The sculptors seem to have run riots craving these beautiful women in various activities. They seem so lifelike and beautiful, and every minute details has been given such importance to. Those graceful nymphs portray human emotions. You see them dancing, painting, holding a parrot, caressing a baby, or scratching their back, or just undressing. These are not exclusive to Khajuraho. You can see them in several Hosellas temples. And then you have scenes from day-to-day life. The book refers to them as secular sculptors. Various dancers, musicians, warriors are coupled with the scene of royal court. A teacher and a pupil, a sculptor with the student, and even the funeral scenes are being portrayed in there. So in addition to all of these, you also see mythical animals and even floral prints. And finally, you see the famous erotic sculptures of Khajuraho. Mithunas mating to a group sex, to even scenes of unnatural sex. And while they do remain in your face, it is such a pity that we miss out the rest of the art carved in those temples. The same way as how we miss the real meaning of Kama Sutra. When we talk about it, it's so fascinating, right? And still most of us take sex for granted. People, sex is beautiful, and that's what Kama Sutra is about. It's deep. It's like a sky and earth indulgent intercourse. The language is beautiful. It is pure in all its form. And I think we should try to understand that rather than just commenting on it like, ye to porn hai. And with that said, that's it. I mean, that's all I knew about Kama Sutra and Khajuraho. So hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, then share it with your friends. I know I'm late with my uploads, but I'm trying my best to give you a good content as soon as or as fast as I can. And all I can say is have a great year, guys. Have a great year. And the last thing that I want to say is bye-bye for now.